Okay, so once again, okay, fine. Hello everyone, good morning and good evening. So this is the first class for React.js, and it's a complete project-based training. Okay, so today is the first class and it's a demo class. Okay, so it means I'm going to explain what is the course structure and what is the course plan and the complete course details. Okay, so what we're gonna learn in the next 30 days. And so I'll explain briefly about with slides. Okay, I'll explain briefly about the course. And then lastly, after first half an hour, I'll explain about the course. And the next, after that, you need to ask some questions if you have, okay, about the course or anything, any queries you have. Okay, so let's start with the demo. And one more thing is, first of all, thank you so much for joining this meeting today. So first thing is, I have muted everyone. Okay, so I don't want to, you know, disturb, because some noises will be there unexpectedly if you unmute your mic. So I have taken a control. So I have muted. Even if you unmute also, it won't work because I have taken control. Don't worry. Once I finish this demo session, I'll unmute. I'll give you access so you can unmute and you can talk to me directly. Okay. So, and still some people joining now. Okay, fine. So let's start. So, okay. So React.js, a project-based training. So, you know, nowadays, React is most popular. Okay, it's very popular nowadays, and it's in the way of front end development, because for every website, you know, front end plays a major role. So in that, single page applications now is a market trend. Okay, so currently the single page applications is a market trend, and in that we have various frameworks like Angular is there, React is there, Vue is there, like multiple things are there, and each framework is having its own pros and cons. Okay, so now in this we are learning React.js, and when compared to Angular, a little bit React is most popular in India as well as abroad. Okay, in UK, US, Australia, and all other states, it's quite popular. And even the React.js we can develop either in JavaScript and TypeScript. Now it was developing in JavaScript. Now it's purely on TypeScript. Okay, so the course which we are learning here is purely on TypeScript. It means the complete React.js we're gonna learn on TypeScript, and even backend technology like Node Express, MongoDB also we will develop in TypeScript, and complete project also TypeScript. So this course is React.js, and the programming languages TypeScript. Okay, don't worry, I'll teach TypeScript first and then we'll jump into the React.js. Okay, so fine. So let's start with the React.js. So here, yeah, what is React.js? So React.js is open source, just like Angular and Vue.js, and React also open source. You don't need to pay any license to use the React.js. It is used to develop the user interfaces. It means the front end part. Okay, for any website, you will see the front end part, right? The navbar, sidebar, the components, the cards and all, which you can see on a website, that's called components. So that user interfaces can be developed by React.js. So React.js is a scheme to develop that rich user interfaces and that much dynamic user interfaces. It's like to handle that state of the application and everything. Okay, routing, navigation, authentication and all. Okay, so this is open source library, and it is to develop a single page applications. We will discuss deeper into what is single page application in the coming classes, don't worry. So single page application is nothing but very simple example I tell you. Generally olden websites, what happens is whenever you open a website, okay, and when you want to navigate inside a website, whatever the link you click, it will keep reloading your browser. I think you might have observed every website, mostly when you click on any other routing in that, when you click on any link in that website, it will be keep reloading. Your browser will be keep reloading because the data actually resides at server side. So it's keep waiting for the data to fetch from the server. But in the single page application is nothing but, of course, you have routings also here. Single page is not just like a one page. It's having multiple pages as well, but you never see a page refresh. Okay. Internally, it's having AJAX calls. So you never see a page refresh. It's just like a desktop application. For example, VLC Media Player is there. So whatever activity you do in that or the editor, like Visual Studio Code, WebStorm, any editor, is a desktop application. You never see a page refresh somewhere, right? So same like that, you can look and feel. And this is most popular nowadays. Okay, so single page applications. And yeah, it is developed by the Facebook. So it initially started in the year 2013. Actually, 2014, Vue.js has come. 2013, React.js. And 2016, Angular has come. 2011 only Angular has come, but it was Angular.js. Okay, just forget about. Now, React has come in the year 2013. And what is the version we are going to learn in this course is current version 17.0.2. And that's what released recently. And this is the newer version. So we'll be learning that one. Okay. So next thing is, yeah, it is, of course, yes. Of course, it is, I think you can see my screen, right? Oh. Did you see my screen? Okay. I thought I have not shared it. Okay, fine. Yeah, got it. Okay, so this is most popular when compared to Angular, because Angular was started earlier, but now React is most popular and slowly Vue.js also getting pickup. Okay, fine. So that's all about React.js. And don't worry, we have a lot of time to discuss React.js examples and all. So you get the more clarity. So next thing is, who can learn this? So who can learn this? It's not a basic course. It is some intermediate level course. It means you need to know some basic programming languages and scripting languages. So one is you have to know HTML first. So HTML means you have to know the tags, like HTML tags, how you make and what are the importance of HTML tags and all. And CSS concepts also. It means how to apply the styles. Okay, how to make the page layout and all. And also you should have a understanding of a programming language called JavaScript. So this JavaScript programming language is must and should, because we will be learning TypeScript. But if you want to learn TypeScript, anyway, TypeScript I'll teach here. But if you want to learn TypeScript, you must know JavaScript, like the programming concepts, DOM, DOM manipulation. So those concepts you must know, and some of the ES6 features also required. So along with that, if you know the CSS framework called Bootstrap, this is added advantage. Okay, so that you can develop the rich UI for the websites. Okay, using Bootstrap. So Bootstrap also required. And if you want to brush up, if you want to get with this technologies again, if you want to brush up again, so I have a YouTube channel that is UI Brains Technologies. You can search in YouTube. So there you can find a playlist where you can find this HTML, CSS, and JavaScript and Bootstrap videos. So that is enough actually to attend this course. Okay. So I hope you all know these concepts. I'm not saying that you must be a master in this technology, but at least you should be in a position to create your own HTML and CSS and having connection with a programming called JavaScript DOM manipulation. So at least that level you must know. Okay, fine. So once you have this knowledge, yes, you're ready to start with React.js. Okay, so in React.js, we have various modules. So we will start level by level. It means we start from a basic. Of course, the course subtitle says that it's a project-based training, but still, we start from what is React.js. Okay, so from React.js, we will start with something called a core module. So in core module, we understand like this. So we create a first application. So how to create a first application with React.js? There is a tool called React App. and we understand the folder structure. So how exactly React is going to work? Okay, so what is the control flow inside? Okay, you must know each and every file and how the flow goes, and because you have to know, right? Okay, so after that, we'll understand how to create components. Component means as a part of UI. Okay, it's a small piece of UI. Actually, the whole website can be divided into partitions. So the small part of UI is called component. So we generally develop a lot of components here. So we can develop components in two ways. One is functional and class. So we learn both. Okay. And then next level. So once you understand how to create a custom component, then we'll start applying the CSS. So how to give some styles to it, like inline, internal, external styles. And once you know how to apply CSS, then you have to understand how to apply bootstrap styles. It's like something rich. You have to write some less lines of code and you get some rich UI. Okay, that one. And then we understand what is props, what is state. It's nothing but generally JavaScript, you do some DOM manipulations, right? So the same way in React.js, how you can perform the event handling, form handling, state management. Okay, the props and interaction between the components. Okay, so two separate components can interact with each other. They can share data between them. So there's such kind of concepts you have to learn. It's like a core fundamental for the React course. Okay, so that things we're gonna learn, and event handling, and we do examples. So my concept is very simple here. First, we will learn the concept. Okay. My thought process is like this. We learn the concept first, and then we will make some small examples on it. And then by mixing all the examples, we will develop some level of application. And like that, we learn every next level of the technology. And then finally, clubbing everything, and we'll make a project. Of course, we'll do multiple applications inside. Okay, and then we'll see the form handling. It's like what is two-way data binding in React.js, and conditional rendering, like how you display dynamic table on the React.js application. And we also understand the life cycle. Okay, every component will have a life cycle. So we understand deeper into the life cycle and the context API. This is another way of state management, HTTP calls. HTTP calls in the sense how you can connect the React application to the server. Okay, of course, React is just for the user interfaces, but generally data should come from the server, right? So how you connect your React application with server backend, and also routing, and we'll make an application called BigBasket application by mixing all this. So in the BigBasket application, it's mainly focused on a curl application. So this will cover all the concepts. See, story is very simple. First, we learn a simple component, how to apply Bootstrap, and then for that component, how to apply props and state, and then event handling, button click and all, how to work, like form handling, how to work, and how to display table, like how to connect to server, routing, everything we learn, right? So we have learned every example separately. Okay, see example separately. By mixing everything, we'll do an application. Okay, and this will become a full stack application which contains the backend as well. Okay. So here you will get the clarity, like every concept of this thing, how can you develop an application? So by this time, almost much of the React knowledge you get, okay, by the time you develop this application. Okay, and then the very important concept in, this is first module, okay? After that, there is important concept called React hooks. So React hooks is a newer way of developing the components. So this we will learn, and here there are some hooks like use state, use effect, use ref, some advanced concepts of React as it is. So here we'll develop the same application with the hooks, and then the more advanced we go to advanced level of React.js, that is Redux and Tunker. So Redux is the mostly used pattern in React.js as well as Angular. In Vue.js also, we use Redux, but it's not exactly Redux. It is Flux plus Redux. Okay, so these are all like state management, how you maintain the application data. Every application is have a UI, right? So for that UI, some sort of data will be there, na? Like table data, card data, user profile data, user login credentials. So everything, every complete application data, how you maintain and how you supply to the each and every component. It's like in your apartment, there will be water plantation, right? It's like you keep the complete water of your apartment in one location and you'll be supplying to every house, every flat, same way. Okay, so the structure, and here also we learn from scratch. Okay, so here we learn event handling, form handling, routing, navigation, everything we learn with Redux concept. So you get the clarity, like including Redux and hooks, how can you develop an application? Okay, and then so by this time you should be have a clear idea about React.js, and after that we start with a few examples and few concepts on server side, because you're not just going to be a React.js front end developer, you're going to be the full stack developer, because we're going to develop a project, so project essence back end should be there. Okay, so we will understand the back end part as well, like Node Express and MongoDB, and then we'll start with the project. So this is the final project, that is name is React Cart, just like Flipkart. Okay, it's an online shopping application, and the highlights like this. So you make the routing system, token-based authentication, and password encryption, and image upload functionality. You can upload the real image of your local system and backend with Node Express and MongoDB. And we use Mongoose for data modeling, and Stripe payment, the credit card payments we use, and the deployment to Heroku. And we also deploy the application to online, so you can verify each. And also the future implementations of the project. It's like I'll give you some tasks on the projects once we develop completely. So you can just take up the task and you can develop yourself. Okay, something more improvements to the project. Okay, so that's where you explore the more about it. Okay, see, by this time, what you understand is we start from very ground level. And before you start with this course, you should not have any knowledge on React. You have already, don't worry. You can explore the even more knowledge with the practical examples. So my thought is very simple. We just start at the basic level. A few examples, clubbing them, one small application like that. So level by level, we came up to here. Okay. And lastly, I'll give you some task on the project. Okay. Almost 99% I'll develop. At least 1%, at least I'll try to give some different kind of tasks. So you can take up that as a challenge, and you can integrate with the complete project, because complete structure is there. This need to integrate, because in company, that's what happens, right? So you join in the middle of the project and they'll give you a task. Hey, please make this functionality, like some purchase functionality and some form, like feedback kind of form you have to make. So you understand the flow first, how front end can be developed, and how back end structure is there, and how can do we have to create a table, like complete flow you need to handle. Okay, so that type of task I'm going to give lastly. So that's about the project. Anything else? One second. I think lastly, you have a course information. Yes, this batch name is 08RCJS evening. So this you must note down. Okay, so this batch name, the batch code you have to note down, because when you are asking questions to me through WhatsApp, okay, so, or phone call, so you just need to tell me this. Okay, so I understand which batch you are, so that in which concept we are in, like that. Okay, so course duration is 30 days. It is for 60 hours. It means daily it will be 2 hours. Okay, and it's completely live and hands-on training. It means daily I'll be joining live in the meeting, and I'll be coding in front of you. Okay, every example, even that the project also, I'll start from scratch. Okay, no copy paste, nothing. We do from scratch, like each and every file we create and each and every line of program we write in front of you. Okay, and as you know, it covers from basics to advanced level. And the very important thing is this one: daily videos, files and slides can be shared for practice. Okay, it means it's not just only attending the live session. if you miss the class, okay, and some people not feasible for this time, 6 to 8, some people not feasible, or they'll be working in a different shift, okay, so maybe it's not feasible for them. So don't worry if you miss the class or you join a bit lately, no issue. Every class is getting recorded, even the current demo session is getting recorded, and every record I'll be give you, because I'll be creating a Google Drive for every batch. So I'll upload every class daily. If you attend or not, I will record the class daily and I'll upload to Google Drive, and I grant access once you pay the fee. Okay, and this is access for lifetime. Okay, you can access this complete what's called these videos and files and slides can be accessible for lifetime, not just 6 months, not just 1 year, lifetime. Okay, and yeah, class timings will be daily 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. Daily 2 hours. Okay, so classes will be from Monday to Saturday, and Sunday will be a holiday. Okay, fine. And so when come to course fees, 5,000 rupees for Indian people, and $100 for others. It's like US people and others. Okay, and what is this screenshot, email, and batch code? Is simple. You need to pay. How you have to pay the fees is, you just need to pay the fee by stating this batch code, okay, 08RCJS evening, and this you need to pay through Google Pay or Phone Pay or Paytm. I think I missed the spelling, PE, right? Yeah, Google Pay or Phone Pay or Paytm to this number. So please note down this number. It's my number, and you can do WhatsApp chat on this number. Okay, so what you have to do is first make the payment through Google Pay or Phone Pay or Paytm to this number, based on this batch code you have to mention, and that paid screenshot to me to send to my email ID, or you send directly to this number as a WhatsApp. Okay, so first pay the fees for this number, and you send me that screenshot to this number or this email ID, okay, with the batch code and your email ID also, so that I'll grant access for the Google Drive and also the live sessions. Okay, so the first three sessions will be free. Okay, first three sessions, it means today, tomorrow, and day after tomorrow, three sessions are free. Okay, just you need to know the like how the class is going on and all. So you can join that free of cost, and then from fourth class onwards, you must pay the fees. Okay, because I'm going to change the meeting ID for the paid people. So you have to join, and only the paid people can able to access the daily videos, class files, and slides. Okay, I hope that's clear, and I'm done with yes, I'm done with the slides, and I'll just grant access for you to talk to me. So one second. Okay, fine. I have given access. So those who want to talk to me, you can just unmute and talk.
Navin, yeah. Can you show me the examples what we are going to develop?
Oh, okay. One second. Actually, I'll show you the previous batch, I guess. Workspace 05. Yeah. So here, core module. Not that one. One second. See, like these modules we have, TypeScript, yeah, core module, and all. Let me enable this.
See, directly you're going to start with hooks, or you're going to start with class components? Because yeah, these days first, only hooks are using, right?
Yes, yes. First, a few examples, only just few examples with the class, and then directly everything on hooks only.
Okay.
Mostly hooks only. Okay, one second. Yeah, this is our core module, man. Okay, so in this first, we started the basics, like to understand the flow structure and the CSS styles. I think I can't run every program, but once again,
yeah, sure.
Bootstrap styles, website, yeah, event handling, and there you have some components like shopping cart, product item, like events. I mean, if you just click on a plus symbol, how it increment the these things and all, and forms binding, data binding, conditional looping, interaction, props, link, context API, servers, contact app, GitHub, routing, and big basket. Next, like hooks, we have Redux, we have shopping. I think I can show some once again. If you want to see the photos, I guess I have in. Okay, in Vue.js, I'm not using my laptop. It is there in my laptop. So just for demo, I just using my desktop only. So I think core module bootstrap. No. Okay. I'll just show you some examples. So this type of example, this is data binding example, how you bind the image, some dates and all. And yeah, this is how you display some dynamic data. 1 minute, there is some events binding. Yeah, this is what shopping cart. You just increment the items to see the grand total and all, because generally every website will contain like this.
Okay.
And conditional looping, yeah, this type of like some conditionally how you display, like I mean this product is not there. I think you're using the speaker, right?
Yeah.
Can you reduce that because it's coming resound? Okay. So here, like if the product is less number of products, it's in stock like that, and out of stock, like how you conditionally display and looping it. Many examples are there. Forms binding. Yeah, this type of form binding with validations. Interaction, yeah, this type of component interaction. So how can you transfer one component to another component data? And forms, life cycle, nothing much. Server connection, I think I have not taken a photo of it. View router, oh, I have not taken pictures of it. 1 minute. Projects, I have, this is actually view, but wait. Maybe give me a minute. 05. For example, if you see the project, you understand. Nodes, if you go, yeah, this is online shopping application. This is how it looks like. So you have a login system and menswear, kidswear, and all. And this is this is how you display the shopping items. And this is kids collection registration. Then you can have a form validations. And once you log in, you get your picture and photo and this logout button. And then you can select the items and add to cart. And this is the cart page. And here the same thing, the plus symbol, minus symbol. We learn, right, in the events binding. In the events binding, we have learned, right, like how to increment the product, this one. The same concept we are going to apply in the project is like this, like plus symbol, minus symbol to increment, decrement, delete, and all. And then you click on checkout, it goes here, and you click on update address also. And then you can pay. And this will be like your profile, and this is payment. Okay. And it'll be order success and your orders page. This is how the UI will be. Okay. And if you want to see the live example, I have hosted for the previous batch. You may get that because we have deployed that to online. One second. I think. Oh, one second. Don't note down, it will change every time. Okay, so we develop in Angular and React. So I'll show you in React social. Not social, shopping. it is deployed live on this Heroku. I told right, we are going to deploy the application to Heroku, like here. We'll deploy to Heroku. That's what this one, Heroku. I think it's still loading. Yeah. Yeah, this is how it will be. See, I showed in the first, we'll take a design, man. I have taken a screenshot, right? See, same design we'll take, and then it'll be like this. I think let me log in. Without login, also you can check the menswear and all. So we have a nice spinner over there, menswear, womenswear. I'm using a big screen. This is a big TV, so I think it's not properly rendered. Okay, in laptop you can see properly. Let me log in. So if you click on login, you get this thing. This is Angular. Oh wait, my React also there. See, both this is in Angular and this is in React. But React validation something different. One second. See, this validation is different. Yeah, you get like this, login success. And see, you have profile picture and all. Just click on this, you can see your profile of it. Okay. You can update address also by enabling it. Okay. And it's a home page, menswear. It's a different spinner we use. Very few images. You can upload also. Yeah, upload. Because I'm the admin, I have login. I'm the admin, so I can upload. But if you don't have admin rights, so you don't have, you can't see this upload. You can't upload also. It will show some error message. You're not admin, you're not supposed to upload like that. Because authentication, authorization, both are there. So if you want to purchase something like that, you can just select the image. You can see the details and you can select some two items, add to cart. This is your cart page. Okay, you can increment the items. See, it's incrementing here. It just price, okay, and total is here. Okay, let's select the kids wear, two items, women's wear. Two items add. So this is 5, 4, 3. Okay, so 20,000 like that. So check out. So you can just select the credit card payments and pay with card. Something like this. I don't know. Anything you can give. I think it's the this is testing, okay. So don't note down this number. This only test mode, okay. It's not a real amount. Yeah. So once it is done, see payment is success, and you get the order success. You place successfully ordered, and the order ID and the person and email ID, his number and date, today's date. Okay, 31st May, total amount 20,000 something. You can take a print of it, like you can just take a, you can save it as a PDF. Okay, or you can done, you can go to homepage. Okay, and you go to orders and you check the latest somewhere here. See, 22,000 and you can orders. Okay, so complete flow, you can see. Okay, this application we develop even somewhat more because here actually the update product option was not there. Once you upload is final, but I want to make the update option also. If you're admin page, you can update the product also. So I will make that version in this batch. Okay, I hope now you get the clarity what type of application we develop.
Yes, but okay. Whatever you showed for Vue.js examples, same examples we will develop.
Yeah, same.
Okay. And everything same is in TypeScript, right?
It's completely TypeScript. Front end, back end, everything TypeScript.
Okay, sure.
100% TypeScript.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Fine. Anybody, any question?
Sir, are we going to integrate with the Gmail? Like, you know, you can log in with Gmail also, right?
Gmail? Of course, we can make Gmail login also, but if you make the Gmail, you can't really understand the real login functionality, because simple, no? If you're using Bootstrap, you can't really understand how internally things are happening. Okay, if you develop using CSS, you understand how the styles are working. So same way we apply here is our own login system. So you clearly understand how you fetch the form data and how you evaluate, how you validate on top of the form data and how you convert to password encryption and all. But if you're using a Gmail login, simply you just have to give the Google API key and it will make the internal process. Okay, so yeah, of course you can make the Gmail login, but thing is generally mostly only this shopping cart websites, mostly social login. So the social kind of websites only, that thing will be there. But mostly if you join the company, so company have internal websites. Okay, so for them, it will be login system like this only, because you can't force your client to have a Gmail account to join with the Gmail, because mostly you join the company email ID only. So that case and this login system is most helpful. So that's why I focus mostly on this. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, fine. Any question?
Sir, can I call you after the course?
Yeah, you can. You can.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay. Okay, fine.
Same time.
Sorry?
From tomorrow onwards, class will be there.
Yeah, same time, 6 to 8. Today just 7 o'clock only, up to 1 hour today, and from tomorrow onwards 2 hours. Okay.
Naveen, I have a question. The project will be done in using Hooks or Redux?
Both. Hooks plus Redux.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, because components and all we'll develop using Hooks only, and Redux is for state management, right? So state management is on Redux.
Okay, thank
you. Plus
Redux,
yeah.
Sir, if I apply job for any company, company requires minimum 2 years experience. So how my resume?
Actually,
for experience.
Yeah, okay. Actually, I as per my understanding, you're asking like how much experience you can gain with this course. Definitely 3 years experience you gain with this course, because this type of application we are developing completely. Generally, if you join a company, they'll give you a task. Only this, you'll be allocated to just develop a small patches kind of. Okay, not a complete application, but here we are developing complete application from the ground level, from the folder structure to the deployment process. So definitely you can gain 3 years of experience. Okay, but there is a condition. Okay, just with 1 month course, how you are getting 3 years of experience, in a sense, you have to practice each and every example properly. And you have to develop your own application, because you should be in a position to develop. It's like we have made this application, right? So same like this, you need to get your own thoughts and try to develop your own application like this much bigger. So that time you can claim 3 years of experience, okay? Not just practicing only classroom example. You should think out of the box, like just make some newer examples and newer thoughts you apply. So definitely you get 3 years of experience on it. Okay, and once you join the company, you can learn even the more advanced concepts of React.
But sir, interviewer asked him to show the experience and how it will be handled.
Okay, you call me, I'll tell you. Okay, one second, you just call me on this number, I'll tell you, because people will keep the gap as experience. Okay, so if you want to claim your gap as experience, so you just call me on it, I'll tell you. Depend on your pass out age, pass out year, and your stream, because you may be computers and may not be computers. So just call me, I'll tell you how the process. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Fine. Anyone? Last few minutes.
Sir, React or React Native is different?
React Native is different. You can, no? This is a website. React Native, Ionic. Is all for mobile apps. Okay, that's different, but if you know the this React knowledge, and you can learn React Native easily.
Sir, in company we will work it with which language? But I mean, TypeScript with React or JavaScript with React?
That we can't tell because it may be because some companies use still JavaScript with React, and some companies will use React with TypeScript. But I can say, if you learn React.js with TypeScript, and it is easy for you to work on React with JavaScript as well.
Sir, which one is popular?
Now TypeScript with React is most popular.
Thank you, sir.
TypeScript with React is most popular in India and as well as abroad. Okay. Okay.
Fine. Yes, sir.
Ranjit.
So after learning, yeah, sir. I'm asking. I'm working as a backend developer in Java.
Okay.
If I learn, I have knowledge in JavaScript and TypeScript also. If I learn React, can I claim 1 year of experience in as a full stack developer?
Yes, of course you can. I said 3 years, right? You can definitely.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
I think it all depends on our practice.
Yes, that's what. Yes, correct.
Learning this course will not help. How much we practice also important.
Yes. Yes. Okay. Anyone? Any question?
Sir, how can you do cloning?
Cloning of what?
One of.
Actually, cloning is a sense, not just cloning kind of. By seeing the design, they'll develop from the scratch. As a copy of it, like okay, sir. I mean, this is the kind of cloning only, no? This is a this kind of one online shopping application. There are multiple online shopping applications. This is a cloning of one, but not exactly same design of it, but you know, clone of at least some online shopping. Okay. Anyone? Any question? No. Okay, so please note down this number. I think the screen, yeah.
Sir, this project is only on front end or back end, sir?
Konsa? Which one?
This online shopping system, sir.
Online shopping, yeah. It's complete full stack, yaar.
Okay,
sir. Back end bhi rahega. Kyunki, see, if you click on menswear, where does this data come from? Back end. Yeah, see, okay. When I click on this link, it will send a HTTP. It will send an AJAX request to the server, and okay, that server. We'll evaluate requests from where the request is coming from, and are you eligible to get data or not? Like it will do some validations, and you get this data from database backend. So it's completely okay. Full stack, merge stack application. It is.
Okay, sir. Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. Anyone? Last few minutes. Okay. Okay. Fine. I guess you're done with the questions, and don't worry, because we're gonna meet daily, right? So when you if you have some questions, you can also ask me tomorrow, no issue. So as I said, first 3 days, like today, tomorrow, and day after tomorrow, Wednesday is the last free session. Okay, these three are the master class, so you can join for free. And third is the last date to do the payment. Okay, so once you do the payment and all the classes, if you do the payment on 4th or 3rd or even 5th also, whenever you do the payment, then you get the access from 31st what is the class is running. So from then, okay, and the complete course will be available on the Google Drive, and I'll be giving you access, and that is access for lifetime. The complete videos, the daily live session videos, and the files which we have developed, the complete source code of it, okay, and the slides, everything you're going to get for lifetime access. Okay, you can actually, the best part here is, no, because in future, if you join the company, if you want to develop this login functionality, okay, your own login functionality, if you want to develop, simple, you just anyway, you attend the course and you have practiced it, right? So after joining company, you may forget the flow, okay, and you need to get the code. So in company, actually, what happens, no, they won't allow you to take a pen drive, because most of the companies, they won't allow any hard disk or pen drive to connect to your company system. Okay, So that case you can't carry your source code, but if you have a source code, you can do the task easily, like the login system. So here the benefit for you is you have the video files, slides, everything on Google Drive. So obviously I don't think Google cannot block. They may block YouTube, they may block Facebook, but Google they can't block. Okay, so Google at least Drive you can access, and you can download a source code from there. And by seeing source code, you understand how to make the login functionality with ReactJS and backend. So just copy paste the source code which we would develop in the class. Okay, with some extra fields if you have, like I have here username, email, password, right? You may have some more extra fields, but with that code, if you copy paste and you just do some minor changes, and you can develop that task in an easy way. And even in future, if you get this type of form validation you want to apply in the company, okay, you may forget the source code. Don't worry, you can download the files which we have developed in the class, right? So that source code you download, anyway, you have practiced it already. So it will be very easy for you to understand the source code also. So you can just apply the source code and what are the fields you wanted, just change it and just apply, just copy paste. Because in company, once you join the software company, they never ask you where you get the code. They only ask you is that code is working or not. Okay, so you have plenty of resources online, but if you have the source code available in your company, the code, the source code which you have learned in the course, okay, so that will be very beneficial because you have practiced it right. So that way, so you can copy paste and you can save your development time actually. Okay, so they'll give you every task. For example, to develop some form validation, they'll give you this. Assume they are giving you 3 hours of time to make this, 3 or 4 hours of time to make this task. But if you have a source code already and you have developed this in ReactJS already, you just copy paste and just change the fields. 5 minutes job, right? And remaining you can just learn some. You can concentrate on you learning new technologies or something. Okay, so your job will be easy even after joining the company. Okay, so that's a plan of it, and that's why I'm not just giving only for 1 year or 6 months, because we never know how long we are going to work on ReactJS in the company. Okay, so it's access for lifetime. Okay, so I hope you got clarity on it. And course fees 5,000 fixed. Okay, and you just need to do the payment on Google Pay or Phone Pay on Paytm on this number, and send me this. This is our batch code. So whenever I call a batch, I'll just use this number. So send a screenshot after payment of this batch code to this number, and you along with your email ID. So that I'll grant access here and also grant access for the upcoming live sessions of this complete batch, the complete course. Okay, so that's all enough for the demo class today. And don't worry, the people who has joined lately for this course and for this class today, I'll be uploading this video on YouTube, because anyways it's a free, right? So maybe many other people also can watch it, and if they are interested, they can join. Okay, that's the only goal. So not all the videos will be uploaded to YouTube. Okay, so keep that in mind. Only first one or two videos will upload, and remaining will upload here. Okay, so that's fine. So enough. Thank you so much for the demo class today, and please join from tomorrow to explore more on React. So tomorrow we will be starting TypeScript. Okay, we'll do a few installations of it, and we understand TypeScript, and we'll start directly a TypeScript program by tomorrow. Okay, and one more thing, if you're already aware of my YouTube channel, yeah, this is, if you just type this one, Navin Sagam, so you can find my YouTube channel here. So in this, I already make some videos on TypeScript. So yeah, there I made some 24 videos on TypeScript. So if you've gone through this TypeScript videos, it'll be very easy for you to understand tomorrow's class. Okay, it's not that I can't explain everything, but if you watch it, it'll be easy for you to understand more detailed knowledge about TypeScript. Okay, so what you do is tomorrow, go through these videos and come back to class tomorrow, and we'll start with TypeScript for a few days, and then directly jump into the ReactJS. Okay, so thank you so much, and I wish you all the very best for your future and ReactJS. Thank you. And tomorrow class will be 6 to 8. Okay, thank you.